Let us pray. Father God in heaven, we have come this afternoon to give you thanks. First of all, thanking you for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and for everything you've done for us through him. And Lord, we want to give you thanks for our nurses, Lord. Thank you for the nurses today, God. If they can make it here in this program, they can make it anywhere. So I thank you for our nurses, for your love for them, and for enabling them and giving them the victory to just pass their courses and to be here for today's special occasion. Bless the families that are here, friends, neighbors, everyone, God. If it weren't for you, this pinning wouldn't be possible. So I thank you, Lord, in the name, God, of our Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, let everyone say, Amen.
Everybody come on in and have a seat. I need to look at you guys, because this is about you. It's my pleasure to welcome the December 2010 graduates of the Associate of Science in Nursing degree program of Atlantic Union College, their proud families and friends, the nursing faculty, college administration, and college church family. This special ceremony is taking place in God's house, and we kindly ask that everyone will be respectful of this holy place. If you need, there is a mother's room which is in full view of the sanctuary, just back to the left. So aren't they a beautiful group of men and women? We are so proud to share their success with you. They have persevered and they have reached their goal. And I was just gonna say, let's give them a hand, but you already did, but let's give them another one. Today is a day of celebration, a time to celebrate the passage from nursing student to professional nurse, passage that often entailed traveling from distant lands, adapting to new cultures, maybe even learning a new language, and separating from family and friends before even starting rigorous studies. What drew this culturally rich mix of students to study at AUC? I will tell you. It is the underlying philosophy of caring in the Department of Nursing and their altruistic commitment to lessen the suffering of mankind and improve the quality of life for others. Our graduating nurses have the ideals and qualities of predecessors in nursing. And I want to assure you that that commitment, as it was when I graduated back in 1972 from AUC, is still the same with our students today. I've taken a little liberty with Florence Nightingale's words because in today's world, we're able to share the profession of nursing with both men and women. So I quote from, except for my liberty of including guys, Florence Nightingale's 1860 notes on nursing. And remember, every nurse should be one who's depended upon. He or she must have a respect for their own calling, because God's precious gift of life is literally placed in her or his hands. He or she must be a sound and a close and a quick observer. And he or she must be a woman or man of delicate and decent feelings. These attributes are applicable to you, graduates. We are so proud to welcome you to the profession of nursing. May you wear your pin with pride and hopefully with fond memories. And to all of you, we are honored to welcome you to this special pinning ceremony today. May we all revel in the success of our graduates.
Good evening. The lecture for today will be found in Joshua 1, verse 9, and it reads, "Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go." Amen.
Our second reading is found in Psalms 46, verse 1. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Amen.
Good afternoon. I'm singing this song for the graduates, and I'd like to congratulate them.
To shine. Thank you, Esther. That was Esther Bazil, whose mother, Marie, is graduating with us today. So thank you very much. It is a pleasure for me to introduce our guest speaker. She has been an instructor here at AUC in the Fitness and Wellness Department since 2001, where she can always be seen with a big smile on her face and positive words for the students. In 2008, she received her Associate of Science in Nursing here at AUC, where she also received the department's Academic Achievement Award for her high GPA. She is a nurse educator for fitness management systems and is currently finishing her Bachelor's of Science at Lesley University. On top of all this, she is very active with volunteering in the Lancaster community. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to Mrs. Ann Mazzola.
I think I'm supposed to turn this on. Is this the wrong one? It's one over there.
Okay.
Oh, here we are. Wonderful. Is it on? Yeah, there we go. Well, just like Colleen Frischi said, I'm not about to stand here and look out at you guys either, because first of all, it's frightening. And secondly, the words that I have today, I want to give to the nurses who I've watched grow in their studies and grow as people over the last couple of years, so I particularly want to talk with them. So first of all, let me say congratulations. I am so proud of each and every one of you. I'm proud as an AUC nurse. I'm proud as an instructor. I look in your faces. I remember the times we spent together, the conversations we had, sharing our hopes and our dreams, and yes, sometimes our fears too, right? So I'm very, very proud to be your speaker this evening. And I know how you feel. It wasn't very long ago that I was sitting right there where you're sitting right now. And I know you're feeling relief. Ah, big sigh, we're here, right? And I also know you're feeling some pride. Yay, I did it! And maybe just a little bit of disbelief. Oh my God, I can't believe I did it, right? And of course, there's also just a little bit of terror, right? I still have to take my NCLEX. It's a little scary, but you're going to be on an emotional roller coaster for a little while, and that's where you're supposed to be. You're going to be sad. Your time here at AUC has come to an end. You're going to be happy, no more studying for a while, wondering what comes next. It's a very emotional time, and that's right where you're supposed to be. And I really do know how you feel. I really do. And first of all, I know you are really sick of school by now, aren't you? You have had enough. But I know also that the last thing you want to hear is you got a few more things to learn before we send you out of here. I'm not talking close enough. Ah, ooh. Whoa, didn't know I had such a deep voice. Well, okay. Well, I know, as I just said, that I know that these students are feeling really pretty sick of school right about now, and that the last thing they want to hear is that they've got a few more lessons to learn before we let you on out of here. Ha ha. But that's just the way it is. So, I can turn these pages here. So I titled my little talk today, but wait, there's more. Because all kidding aside, there really are some things that I've learned at my advanced age and through all the different careers that I have had that I wanted to pass on to you. I know that you're all smart. You wouldn't be here if you weren't. And you know that you need to continue your education to be the good nurses that you all strive to be. For some of you, you'll go on to get other degrees, advanced practice degrees, specialty certifications, and goodness knows you'll be doing those CECs, those continuing education credits that you need to maintain your license. But that's not the learning that I'm talking about here today. I'm talking about learning about yourself. I want to share some lessons for you so that you can be the best that you are meant to be. So, what do I mean? Lesson number one, God's not done with you yet. No matter where you are on your life's journey, you're still a work in progress. As I said, God's not done with you yet. For some of you, nursing will be your first real job, fresh out of school, still wet behind the ears, as we used to say. And for some of you who are a little more of a certain age, a little more mature, this may be your second or your fourth, or if you're anything like me, possibly your sixth career move. But the point is, it really doesn't matter where you are in your career. It's just one leg of the journey. Now, for some of you, it'll be a really long leg of the journey. Maybe you're going to comprise all of your nursing, all of your working life as nurses, and good for you. Being able to find your passion early in life and be able to follow it is truly a gift from God. I didn't plan this very well. I should have had a stand or something for my speaker. But for those of you for whom this is a career change, or if it turns out that nursing is just a stepping stone to someplace else, know this. This is where you are supposed to be right now. And nothing that you have learned here or will learn anywhere is ever wasted, no matter where your life's journey may take you. For example, I have had numerous careers over the year. I started out in investment management, I've been a reporter, I taught kindergarten, I have done all sorts of things, and when I started with nursing school, I thought, do I really want to do this? I mean, for goodness sakes, can't I just pick something and stick with it? But as I look back, I realize that every one of those jobs that I had really did prepare me to be a better nurse. For example, helping me in nursing school was the fact that I worked with attorneys when I was first out of college the first time. And I learned that words have exact meanings, very exact meanings. And if you know what those meanings are, then you can do a better job at what you need to do. So for example, I learned hyperkalemia. What does that mean? Hyper, too much. Calcemia, calcium. Emia, of the blood. Oh, too much calcium in your blood. Then I was able to figure out, well, what does that mean for my patient? How am I going to treat that? Or sarcopenia, I saw that with older folks in the nursing homes. What the heck does that mean? Well, sarco meaning of the muscle, penia meaning a weakness or a wasting. Oh, age-related sarcopenia, maybe these folks aren't as strong as they used to be. Maybe they're going to be prone to falling. It's good to know these things. And also, when I was a reporter, that was probably the best training that I could have for nursing school. Because as a reporter, I'd have to sit through these interminable meetings, listening to planning board meetings or school committee meetings. And these people would blah, 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 blah for hours and hours at a time, and I was bored stiff. But I had to go back to the newsroom, write a story that somebody could read in 5 minutes that would be interesting and would have meaning for them. So I learned very quickly to take all that information, figure out what the need-to-knows were, and what the nice-to-knows were, so when I got to nursing school and I was bombarded with all that information, I was able to figure out, what do I really need to know? So it was helpful. Now, what in my past life had me become a teacher here that helps me as an instructor at AUC? I was a kindergarten teacher. Enough said. So, remember, all learning is valuable. Whatever experience you get, you bring to whatever job, will help you learn more. So take every opportunity to learn to increase your education. There's a poster that hangs up in the gym, and it says, if you think education is expensive, try ignorance. But wait, there's more. Lesson number two, not all learning will take place in the classroom. You'll be learning from your patients, your coworkers, learning things every day from every walk of life. Do not assume you know everything. You'll be exposed to people with different cultures, different points of view. Learn from them. I always say at the end of each of the semesters when I'm with you folks for the last time, I always learn more from you guys than you could ever possibly learn from me. Sometimes it's very specific. I had a student who helped me learn how to swim. I never knew how to put my face in the water and be able to, without holding my nose, and she said, oh, it's very easy, you can do that, just hum. The nice thing about it is it worked and I was able to pass it on to other people. So I've learned all different things from you folks. I'd hope that you will do the same and pass it on. But wait, there's more. Lesson number three, hang in there, baby. Perseverance, something about that Mrs. Frischi was talking about a couple of minutes ago. You all had to go through quite a lot to get here. And I know when I look in your faces, some of the struggles that you had. trying to raise your children, manage jobs, commute, come from a different culture, speak a different language. These are all things that you needed to do in addition to all of those studies that you had. Now, our youngest daughter, Audrey, goes to UMass Dartmouth, and I am proud to say, proud mom, I got to brag here for a moment, she's an honors student, she lives in the honors dorm. It is known as the quiet dorm. Guess who else lives in the quiet dorm? That would be the nursing students. So I said to Audrey, well, what are they like? Because, of course, having been a nursing student myself, I wondered what it was like at UMass Dartmouth. And she said, I don't know, Mom, I've never seen them. They're always studying. So that's my youngest daughter. Our oldest daughter, Allison, lives out in Colorado. She's married with three children, and she was a pre-med student. Took all the pre-med classes. She decided, with two of her children being very young, maybe she'd back it off a little bit and just go to nursing school. Catch the gist? Yeah. So, last time I talked with her, she's in pre-nursing, and she said, you know what? I haven't cleaned my house in 3 months. My kids are running around in clothes that are too small for them. I don't have time to breathe. Nursing school is indeed one of the hardest things that you will ever do. So, after all of this, you may be thinking, I'm going to take a break. You might get a little complacent. I worked really hard. I'm done. You're not done. Don't be complacent. Set a goal for yourself. Keep learning. Keep pushing. Even if you just get one baby step at a time, one step forward, two steps back, three steps forward, keep moving. I like to tell the story about clients I had as a nutritional educator and people wanting to lose weight, and they'd get frustrated because they'd say to me, why aren't I losing weight more quickly? Why is it taking so long? And I'd say, you know what? Slow and easy does it. 1 year from now, you're going to be 1 year older. Wouldn't you like to be that much closer to what your ultimate goal is? Conversely, don't be too hard on yourself, because everybody fails, and that is how we learn. When we are always succeeding, that's wonderful. We learn from that as well. But how many times have you done something particularly boneheaded, only to fix it, and you say to yourself, whew, I'm never going to do that again, and you don't, do you? So give yourself the opportunity to say, whew, I'm never going to do that again. But wait, there's more. Lesson number four, be careful what you wish for. I want all of you to think very carefully about how you define success. We all know successful people who have lots of money, drive fancy cars, live in big fat houses, and they're miserable, aren't they? Because just because you have a job that pays well isn't going to make you happy. And unfortunately, I've seen a lot of folks come to me saying, how do I get in a nursing program? Because nurses get paid a lot. If that's why you want to be a nurse, let me tell you, you're in it for the wrong reasons. You're never going to be happy. Because even if these things pay well, and even if you are able to keep up with the Kardashians or whoever those people are on reality TV, it's not necessarily going to make you happy. Think about the sacrifices that you had to get there, to have all of these things. And studies support that up to a certain point, sure, having some money, having the ability to do the things you want will lead to happiness. But above a certain point, guess what happens? The opposite is true. It makes you unhappy. You've given up simply too much, and it's frankly not worth it. So, what I'd like to suggest to you is that you practice wanting enough. Enough money to put food on your table, a roof over your head, to do the things you need to do to lead a successful life. But remember this, happiness comes from within, it's not a paycheck. And as the old saying goes, happiness is not having what you want, but wanting what you have. But wait, there's only one more. I promise not to talk all night long. Lesson number five, God don't make no mistakes. So we're back to where we started, aren't we? With God's plan for you. So trust in God. And I hope each and every one of you are very proud of the fact that you are Adventist nurses, regardless of your faith tradition, Methodist, Catholic, Hindu, Muslim, Buddhist, whatever you are, be proud of the fact that you have an Adventist health education. Because I'll tell you, one of the companies that I do work for, Fitness Management Systems, that was mentioned earlier, we do a lot of health promotion activities for corporate clients. And a lot of those activities require RNs. Do you know that they won't work with anybody except AUC nurses? They've had other folks in the past, but they come in, they have a scowl on their face, it's like they're doing you a favor by being there, collect their paycheck, and off they go. We, on the other hand, go in with a smile on our face, truly try to help the people that we're talking with, counsel them, really care about the outcome of these folks, which is what nurses should do. And that is a truly wonderful thing that you should be proud of. Because survey after survey shows that people that we hold in authority that we should trust, our doctors, our lawyers, policemen, all the various people we interact with, who do you think in these surveys come out at the top of the list consistently? It's the nurses. People trust their nurses. And we know that, right? We know hospitals are built for nurses, aren't they? Doctors could do their surgeries in surgical suites. You could have all sorts of procedures done elsewhere. But hospitals exist so nurses can take care of these people. So remember what an awesome responsibility that is. But more than that, what an awesome privilege that is. You will be with your patients during the best of times, when there's a healthy delivery of a miraculous baby, brand new boy. You'll be with your patients during the worst of times, holding their hands when they go to sleep in the Lord. And you will be with them for everything in between. So, please remember what an awesome responsibility, what an awesome gift you have been given. So on that, I'm going to end as I begin, by saying congratulations again to each and every one of you. We are so, so proud of you. And I'd like to conclude with a quote from Tiny Tim, from Charles Dickens' classic, A Christmas Story, which I think is very apropos at this time of year. God bless us, everyone. Thank you.
This is a very special day, and I know it is to all of you and all of you that are graduating. This is our very first December graduating class, and I think it's our largest graduating class, and we're all very proud of you, all of your faculty. God is so good. And we're proud of all your accomplishments. I wish I could give every one of you an individual award because you all have worked very hard. You've studied hard, you've hoped, you've endured, you've worked diligently, you've thought carefully, and you've just put everything into this process of becoming a nurse. But your instructors have chosen a few of you to receive special awards, and I have the privilege of giving these awards to you. So for the most improved nursing, the first award goes to Bernard Joseph. Another most improved nursing goes to Mary Titus. For clinical accomplishments, this award goes to Trish Lynch. And also for clinical accomplishments, this award goes to Caitlin Yahumchik. For academic accomplishments, this award goes to Elaine Sommel. And for academic and clinical accomplishments, this award goes to Lee Baldarelli. We wish all of you the best, and we hope you'll keep in touch with us, too. Thank you.
Can you hear me? This is important. Okay, so this is why we're all here, and I just want to take a moment because I see the pinners are up here. When you come up, we're going to make this really special for everyone here. Each one of these graduates, what's special about our pinning is they get to choose who pins them. And the pinner is another registered nurse, which is it's a huge honor. So when your graduate is called, if you could come all the way up to the steps, and there's a little, your pinner is going to stand on the blue. Stand right in front of them. Take your time, and then turn and take a picture. Okay, take your time. That's really important. All right? Right?
Yes.
I already told them. They've had to deal with me all semester, so they know. So, without further ado, Tin Ung. If we could hold our applause for. As a nurse, I plan to further my career in the art of nursing. The pinner can come up. Okay. To pursue my MSN as a nurse educator in public health preventative care, here I can master my craft assisting patients in an acute setting to help prevent chronic illness, infectious disease, and empower them to live a healthier life. I chose the career of nursing. I have always known I wanted to be a nurse and knew from the moment that I started my first direct patient care occupation as a CNA, nursing is a field that is always evolving and requiring a person to better themselves. The person who is pinning her today is her instructor, Diane Kitty Quick.
Lee Baldarelli. Lee intends to integrate nursing with holistic alternative medicine that focuses on education, prevention, and healing. Examples of these avenues are chronic illness and diabetic counseling. She wants to further her education in the study of the human body and the process of healing, to use nursing as a tool to incorporate caring measures for the sick. Pinning her is Mrs. Diane Kitty Quick, who is her nursing instructor.
Marie Bazil. After graduation, I will complete my bachelor's in nursing at AUC. I will be working in the public health field. Later, I will be working as a nurse manager because I already have a bachelor's degree in information system and a master's degree in management. I want to be a nurse because I want to be able to provide excellent and compassionate care to a diverse population. Pinning her today is Sandra Laverse, her sister-in-law.
Steve Delma. Steve plans on continuing and getting his bachelor's and then going straight for a master's degree. After that, he'd like to get into nursing management. In the meantime, he says, I'm continuing my education. I'd like to work in a hospital. And why did he choose nursing? Because he loves helping people, and he felt there was no other career that could affect someone's life more significantly. Pinning him today is his clinical instructor, Fawn Gagnon.
Naomi Disrocious. First of all, I want to thank God for making this joyous day possible. I would like to also thank my professors and everyone else who supported me in this success. Last but not least, I would like to thank my family for their encouragement and devotion. I couldn't have done it without them. After graduation, I would love to find a job and continue my thirst for knowledge by furthering my education in the nursing field. She chose nursing because it was something that I have always wanted to do. Nursing is the best way to help people. Pinning her today is her mentor, Dr. Lenora Follett.
Allison Gallant Lake. Allison says, I would like to further my education and get a job in the pediatric critical care setting. She states that nursing is a career that is both challenging and rewarding. She has admired her mother all her life for being a successful nurse who is passionate about her job. She says, I have always wanted to follow in her footsteps. And pinning her today is Faith Gallant, who is Allison's mother.
Melissa Gem. Melissa plans to complete her BSN degree and become a pediatric nurse. She chose the career of nursing because I worked with children as a medical assistant and wanted to further my education to provide a higher level of care. Pinning her today is Teresa Stone, her friend.
Melissa Gregonis. She states her objective is to continue with employment through UMass as an RN, and she would like to continue her education and obtain her BA. In the future, she says, I will work as an RN and open my own hair salon and spa. She chose nursing because it's the right profession for me, and pinning her today is her friend, Haley O'Halloran.
Amy Hannon. Amy's professional goals is to complete her BSN degree. She is intended on focusing on oncology. She chose nursing because I love to help people who are in need. I worked as a CNA for 2 years and generally enjoyed helping and caring for people, and I want to be able to provide her with a higher level of care. Pinning her today is her oncology clinical instructor, Elizabeth Marachka.
Elizabeth Hill. Elizabeth states that she would like to work as a PD or a maternity nurse. And she chose nursing. She says it's exciting and a rewarding field that requires dedication and hard work. Pinning her today is Christine Hunt, a family friend.
Caitlin Yehemchek. Caitlin's goals are, I would like to work on a medical surgical floor to start my career. One day I would then like to pursue a master's degree in nursing and to experience the endless opportunities of the nursing field. She chose to pursue nursing to make one's hospitalization as comfortable as possible by providing care with compassion and dedication. It was while I was working as a PCA that I realized that nursing is the calling for me. Pinning her today is her mother, Caitlin Yehemchek.
Bernard Joseph. Bernard states that he has, even though nursing has been grueling and arduous, he said he'd like to thank a few people. First of all, to his teachers. Thank you for reminding me that nausea, vomiting, and risk for infection are not the only nursing diagnosis. When your instructor says to run to your patient's room to see something to the next class of 301, please don't run into the room. Special thanks to my clinical instructor, Norlene Mondeser. Special thanks go to my mom and especially to my wife, Diane, the boys, Bernard and Ely. Thank you. And his goals are to pass the board and to find a job, but we're gonna go on. He's got lots of goals and lots of things he'd like to say, but we want to acknowledge the people who have pinned him is Dr. Ninon Amertel pinned him, and he wants to give recognition today to his sister, Gina Lynn Reming from Quebec, Canada.
Abby Batu Kamara. Abby's goals are, I plan to take my board exam within 6 weeks and continue my classes for my BSN degree. I would like to work on a medical surgical floor, preferably in a teaching hospital, so that I can gain experience and develop a strong background in nursing. She chose nursing because I believe nurses make a difference in people's lives. As a child growing up, I was always interested in the medical field. As a nurse, I can see myself at the bedside, listening to a patient's concern, worries, and fears, as well as giving comfort and support. Pinning her today is Mrs. Colleen Fritchie, her former classroom instructor.
Trish Lynch. Her professional goals are to continue to obtain my BSN. Future plans are for missionary and education. She says, I have cared for people for quite some time, from babies to the elderly. I didn't say to myself, I want to be a nurse. So I believe it was God's plan for me. Today, pinning her is her mother, mentor, and friend, Kathy Rosansky.
Tammy Matuszewski. Tammy's professional goals is to continue her education and achieve her bachelor's in nursing. I would like to start my career by working on a medical surgical unit to advance my nursing skills and eventually specialize in maternity and pediatrics. My mother has always been my inspiration in becoming a nurse. She has always encouraged me to go to school to be whatever I want. I chose to be a nurse. She has always told me how hard it is sometimes to be a nurse, but there are also times that are very rewarding too. Pinning her today is Cindy Sund, her mother.
Erica McKenzie. Erica states, I will be continuing my education and obtaining my bachelor's degree in nursing. Then I plan to join the Air Force as an officer and desire to work on an OBGYN nurse. Especially, I want to work in the NICU. I will also be continuing my education to obtain a master's degree. She says, I felt like nursing was the only job I felt called to do. When I committed myself to doing nursing school, I fell in love with the profession. I can't imagine myself doing any other job. Today, pinning her is her boyfriend's mother, Lynn Fanuccio.
Eni Menezes. Eni's goals is to initially continue developing and acquiring new skills in a professional healthcare facility to help me mature the choices to do more specific field. She chose the profession of nursing because she has a passion to serve and care for others. Pinning her today is her friend, Rosalie Ferry, former AS graduate.
Melinda Minot. Melinda's professional goal and plans after graduation is to pursue a nursing career in public health. She says, I chose the profession of nursing. Through nursing, I will be able to minister to humanity's physical, spiritual, emotional, and social needs. Pinning her today is Mrs. Lucille Williams, a registered nurse.
Melanie Riley. After graduation, I would like to obtain a job as a medical surgical nurse. Once I have gained some experience, I plan to continue my education to finish my BSN and further my MSN. My ultimate goal is to be a nurse practitioner and possibly specialize in either pediatrics or emergency nursing. I have always had an interest in the medical field, and I began working as a PCA. Pinning her today is Jillian Colby, a friend.
Hannah Roy. She says that her professional goals is, I'm planning to continue my education and become a family nurse practitioner. She loves to help people. That is why she chose the profession of nursing. She loves to learn about the human body, its anatomy and physiology. Pinning her today is her class instructor and friend, Colleen Fritchie.
Pauline Russell. Pauline's professional goals are to gain some experience in the field of nursing to determine which aspects of the profession I enjoy the most. In the future, take classes towards a master's in the area that I concentrate in. She chose the profession of nursing because she truly enjoys helping people. This profession allows her that to happen through many avenues. Pinning her today is her aunt, Lynn Gillis.
Thank you. Mary Titus. Her professional goal, she says her immediate goal is to secure a position as a hospice nurse supporting patients and families as they face terminal illness. My future goal is to continue my education. She chose nursing to provide comfort, support, guidance, and encouragement to those in need. Pinning her is Kimberly Dunker, her nursing professor. Cheryl Lynn and Nick Urbina. Their professional goals, Nick and Cher plan to use the knowledge they have recently acquired to expand their business into the healthcare field. It is their desire to further the ministry of health. They chose nursing originally because to have a career, which they would be able to have flexible schedules in order to spend more time with their children. Pinning them today is their nursing instructor and their friend, Kimberly Dunker.
Melissa Vandenbroek, why did you choose the career of nursing? I chose nursing after a fellow classmate, Victor Oasu, passed away in a car accident our senior year of high school. He had been accepted to Johns Hopkins University in Maryland and planned to attend and enter the medical field. I was undecided with what I wanted to do with my own life, and I came to the conclusion that I would try the medical field for him. And that way, when we met in heaven, I could tell him about it. Now that I am here, there's nothing else I would ever want to do in my life than be a nurse, and I hope to always keep Victor's passion for life and for me throughout this career. My prayer is that I always say, before I walk into the hospital, God, please help me treat and take care of each patient as if it was Victor in the bed. Pinning her today is her brother, Jared Vandenbroek.
Mermonde Virilis. After graduation, I plan on sitting for my boards and continuing with my education by God's grace. At this moment, I would like to acknowledge my loved ones, friends, teachers, and Chaplain Sierra, who were there for me, whether through prayers, giving words of encouragement, and even to those who were there to wipe my tears during stressful times. I made it today not by my own strength, but by God's help and through your support. To my mom and dad, thank you for always being there. Thank you for being the best parents a daughter could ever wish for. I love you with all my heart, today and forevermore. And pinning her today is her clinical instructor, Nellie Mayers.
Brittany Weavers. Brittany's professional goals are to obtain a job as a medical surgical nurse. Once I gain some experience, I plan to finish my master's degree and become a nurse practitioner. I have always been interested in the medical field and worked as a PCA and wanted to provide a higher level of care. Pinning her today is her friend, Jillian Colby.
Elaine Zamo. Elaine says, I would like to continue my education and finish my BS. I am planning on working 2 to 3 years as a med-surg floor to be exposed to different experiences so I'll be able to enhance my knowledge in the medical field. She chose nursing. I truly enjoy helping people. Sickness is the point of biggest vulnerability that a person may face. I want to be able to make a difference in a person's life. The nursing career also allows me to be very flexible because I can branch out to many fields and be very versatile. Pinning her today is her teacher, Kitty Quick.
At this time, we're going to take a short moment for the graduates to hand out some roses. This shouldn't take more than 5 minutes, and then they're going to join us back on the stage. Thank you.
Grads, please, time. As the grads are returning to their seats, will all the nurses in the audience please stand and repeat the pledge with us? 2 seconds. Ready, grads? Okay, let's repeat the nursing pledge together. In the full knowledge of the obligation of undertaking, I promise to care for the sick with all the skill and understanding I possess, without regard to race, creed, color, politics, or social status, sparing no effort to conserve life, to alleviate suffering, and to promote health. I will respect at all times the dignity and religious beliefs of the patients under my care, holding in confidence all personal information kept close to me and refraining from any action which might endanger life or health. I will endeavor to keep my professional knowledge in the spirit of myself and to give all the support and cooperation to all members of the health team.
Please bow your heads with me as we have the benediction. And now the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Be strong and courageous. Do not be terrified. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Amen.